Hi, today top is string in C language. Today topic is the string in our C language. First of all, what is the string? So string is nothing but group of characters. Group of characters is called string. So here, regarding to array concept, character array, that is nothing but we are collecting the number of sequential characters. So simply our character is also called the character array is also called string. So here one small difference between there, here in our string there is a storage like this. How to declare means declaration. How to declare the array? For that one we can take char string, so that's why str, and after that we can mention the size, that means how many number of characters you want. So now I will take one simple example, like that is a char name and take the 20 characters. So that means here character, that is one type of array, that means character array here, so that it is a name is a string which will be contains maximum number of characters is 20. Now let us take, now I am simple, take one more example like char name of 4. Now I am take that this is a name of 4, that means here how it will be storing, like means same base like this one, base done array, this is the name, index value 0 1 2 3. So here let us assume I will be taken the string is nothing but just like hi. So here it is a character, that's why it must be enclosed within a single quotation. Then after that, every string must and should be ending with slash zero. Actually it will be look like as two characters, but it will be treated as a single character. After slash it is a zero, it is not a O, it is not a letter, English letter O, it is a zero. That means every string ending with slash zero. So how to define, that means this is a declaration, how to define means, like I will be taken char name of 4 is equals to, then within flower bracket, that is the first letter is the H, second letter is the I, A, and third letter is the I, and last letter is the slash zero. So please remember here, every character must and should be enclosed within a single quotation. Every letter must and should be enclosed within a single quotation, and each letter separated by the comma. So this, that's why it's a collection of characters. So that's why it is a string. So this is the concept belongs to our what is a string, how to declare the string, how it will be stored the string. That means every character must and should be ending with the slash zero. This is the way of assigning the values into the character array, that means string. Now by using standard input out function, how to read and display string. So for this one we can use the, there are the one method, that means for reading we are use the scanf. Scanf is a predefined function which is used to read any data type. If you want a string, then we are using the format string, that is nothing but a %s. For displaying, we are using the function, that is the printf. Printf is also one type of displaying function in C language. Here It will display any data type. It is also predefined function. It display any data type like integer, float, double, single character or multiple characters. That is nothing but a string. So for displaying the string, it will be taken like %s. So here one simple small difference here, at the time of reading by using the scanf, at the time of displaying by using the printf, it will be works only one word. That means it is not possible to the multiple words as a string. If you want string, that means for example here I will be taken by using scanf like hai space hello. My intention is my string is hi space hello, but by using scanf it is not possible to the hi hello because of it will be contains two words. So by using scanf it is not possible to read a string. So it is a string, so that's why it is a entirely string, but it will be contains the separated by the spaces. So that's why by using scanf it is not possible to read a entire string. So, and also by using the printf, it is also not possible to display the multiple words. So, to avoid that problem, they are introducing our C, that means Dennis Rich, his author, he will be provide some string functions to read a string, to display a string. So, by using scanf, we can read the string with the help of control string arguments, that is the %s. But it will be read only one string. To overcome this problem, our string will be maintained some functions, such type of obligations. So now the first string, that means now I will be explain what are the string handling functions. What are the string handling functions? First of all, what are the problems? That means what are the operations on the string? So these are already predefined function. First one is, if you want to read multiple words. The next one is write, that means or display multiple words. And third one is, if you want to count the number of letters in a string. And next one is, if you want to display, that means if you want the display or you want the just reverse of the string, that means if you want to convert our original string into the reverse string, then we can use the reverse string. That means then after that, if you want to copy from one string to another string, that means you want the copied process, that means from one string to another string. The next one is, if you want to combined, that means you want the combined the both two or more than strings, then you can use the combined. Then after that, if you want comparison, that means you can also use the comparison of two strings like this, of two strings. So that means these are all the functions: read multiple words, write multiple words, count the number of letters, and display or reverse the string, and copied and combined and comparison of two strings. And one more thing, if you want to convert a original string into lowercase letter, convert string into lowercase letters. And one more thing, that means you want to convert into uppercase letters, that means capital letters. Means here, what are the operations are possible? That means these are called string handling function. First one is, sir, I would like to read a single word, that means multiple words or word, single word. That means you want to read a string, It is a display string. That means you want to read the string, display the string, and number of letters in that string. Then after that, you want to convert original string into the reverse and you want the combined or copied from one string to another string, and after that you want to combine two or more string into a single string, then after that you want to comparison of two strings, then you want to convert our original string into the lowercase letter, and also you want to convert into the uppercase letters. So for this one, how to handle and our C language, for this one we can use the string handling functions. So now simply I will get the what are the functions of this. If you want to read a string, that means for this one we can use the, that is get as. It is a function, it is a predefined function. So simply get as is a string handling function. It is already predefined function which is used to read a string. The next function is put as. It is also one type of, it is also one type of string handling function. It is used to display the string. Then next one is, if you want to count the number of letters in a string, then we are using the strlen. Then after that, if you want to reverse a string, then we are take the strrev. By using this function, we can reverse original string into the reverse of the string. Then after that, if you want to copy it, that means one string into the another string, then we are using the function, that is strcpy. Then after that, next one is, if you want the combined two or more strings, then we are using the strcat, is a function which is used to combine the two or more strings. Then next one is, if you want comparison of the two strings, then we are using the strcmp, is a function. Strcmp is a function which is used to comparison of two strings. But here there is one more function is available, that is the strcmpi. Strcmpi, it is also one more type of function. Next I will be explain what is the difference between the strcmp and strcmpi. The next one is, if you want to convert our original string into the lowercase letter, that means we are using the function, that is strlwr. And last one is, if you want to convert into the uppercase letter, then after that strupr. So these are the string handling function. It is a reading, it is displaying, it is a count or length of the string, it is a reverse of the string, it is copy of the string, or combine the two or more strings, and comparison of two strings, and after that this is also comparison of two strings, and after that convert our original string into the lowercase letter. This is the convert into original string into the uppercase letters. Now we will discuss one by one with syntaxly. Okay, now I will be taken the first function, that is the get s. So here get s is a function which is used to reading a string. But before this one, our Dennis Rich will be provide an include function, that means hash include string dot h for supporting all 10 functions. That means if you want to use this function, get s, put s, string length, string reverse, string copy, string concatenation, string comparison, and lower and upper, for all using these functions, you must be use the one header file or one including function, that is nothing but a hash include string dot h. Okay, so now if you want the get s function, you must and should be include using the function, that is the hash include using library function. It is a library, that means string dot h. So now I will be explain what is the get s. So here, if you want string, that means I would like to take one string, that is a char name of 10. So how to read a string? So for this one, we can take the simply get s name. So by using this function, we can read the string with many number of words. By using scanf, we can read only one word. By using this get s, we can use the many number of words as a single string. Okay, this is the syntax, and this is the for the get s function. So for example, now I will be taken, that means in at the time of entering the data, now I am typing h a i h e l l o, means 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Please remember, 1 2 3 space is also counting. That means 4 5 6 7 8 9. Hi, hello is a one string. This is one type of string, but it will be contains the two words. And one more thing, please remember, here how many letters? 9 letters. There is a capacity 10. I already given one more length. That means it will be treated as a, just like means it will be automatically, that means slash 0 automatically included in that string. In that string, that means slash 0. That means how it will be storing, like in this way. H A I space H E L L O, then after that last character is the slash O. This is the process to store in memory. This is the space, this is the, like this one. So every string will be represented like this one. So this is the nothing but how to read a string. So now if you want display, then simply you are taking the put S. Put S, that is the name. So after that we are adding the semicolon, put S name. That means it is used to display string. That means what is the output here? For this one you can get the hi, hello. So this is the simple concept, belongs to the hi, hello. That means this is the output of the string. That is the second one. For all this one we must use the as include string.h. Then after that we can take the strlen of, that means name. So here please be remember one simple point is there. Actually according to our memory storage, that is the H A I space H E L L O slash J, means all 10 letters are fillable. All 10 letters are covered. So now here it will be count the number of letters occupied for this variable. So it will gives, we are expecting 10. Sorry, it is wrong. So at the time of string length, it will be excluded. We are excluding the null character. That means what is the output for this one? It gives only 9. It does not count the slash 0. That means 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Hi, hello, what are the length is there? There is only 9 letters occupying. It does not count the slash 0. That is the specialty in the strlen. Then after that, strlen, that means it will be count the number of letters in a string. So what is the syntax means? Here we are writing the syntax like this one, int strlen, then after that we can write the string name, string variable. Actually this is the syntax. Why? Because it will be, it is the integer data. So that's, this is the syntax for the strlen. That means how to count, that means it will be assigning some variable. So that's why I am taking the int c. Then after that, c is equals to strlen in bracket, then use the name. So now what is the c value? If you want to display the c value, that means printf percent d comma c, then what is the output here? The output is 9. C means there is a number of letters is the 9 that will be stored in the integer variable, that is the C. Then after that if you want to display, then it will give the 9 is the output. This is about the string length. Then very easy, based on the single, based on the our single string, we can take one more thing, that is the strrev. Strrev means it will be convert original string into the reverse of the string. That means the same data, you will take the H A I space H E L L O. Here it will be counted. So here string reverse means it will be display the reverse of the string. How it will be display? Like O L L E H space I A I. So this is of the reverse of the string. So what is the input data? Hi, hello. It will be, if you want display in reverse order, hi, hello. This will be like the strrev function. That means reverse of the string. Then after that, one more function. Now, if the data will be like this one, means the data, for example, I am taking the name is equals to like this one. H A I H-E-L-L-O. For example, if I am to take the data H-E-I-H-E-L-L-O. Then if you want to use the STRLWR name, that means if you want to convert this entire string will be into the lower. There are the H capital, I capital, H capital. But I want string lower. That means you want to convert all string. That may be either lower case or it may be in the upper case. But our output will be only in the small letter. That means what is the output here? That means H A I H E L L O. That means our original string will be converted into the lower case letter. Then after that, I will be taken one more function str-upr. That means it will give our original string will be convert into uppercase letter. Even though that is the small and capital, but we want the only all are the uppercase letter. H-A-I-H-E-L-L-O. This is the function of the str-upr and str-lwr. The next function, before going to the next function, I would like to take one simple example. Like I will be taken one string, that is a character string 1 is a 20, and char str 2, that is a 20. Now my concept is I would like assign char str 1 20 is equals to, that means you want assign like H A I, then after that slash 0. So this is my intention to store the values in. That means there is a 20 capacity. That means there is a maximum capacity is the 20, but I am storing only 3 letters. Now my intention is I would like to copy string 1 into string 2. Here my intention is I would like to, what is the copy of the data? What is the copy of string 1 will be copied into the string 2. So that's why we are using the function strcpy. That means I want store, that means str2. This is the destination string. Where is the store string? Str1. So this is enough. Now our string 2 is also contained, str2 is also contains high. Because of here, this means this is the source, this is the destination. So what is the syntax based on this one? Strcpy destination string, destination string comma source string, source string. So this is the syntax. That means what is the function of strcpy? By using strcpy we can copy one string into the another string. That means sourcing into the destination string. This is about the strcpy. The next function, that is strcmp function. That means if you want comparison, so for this one I will be taken one more two strings. That is, I will be taken example like string 1. That means char string 1 20, that is equals to HAI. Then next one is str2 char str2 is equals to HAI. So please remember here, this is the small HAI, this is the capital HAI. This is a, both are high. But if you want to comparison, that means now I would like to compare strcmp function by using str1 comma str2. Now how it will be comparison? Here how it will be comparison means both string 1 and string 2. The string 1 and both string 2, both are the equal. That means if both are equal, that means str1 is equals to str2, when it will give the result is 0. If it is 0, both strings are equal. For example, str1 is greater than str2. That means the first string is greater than second string, then it gives the positive value. For the next one, if the first string is less than string 2, then it will give the negative value. means please remember here how it will be gives the integer values, is the positive value or negative value, it is a zero. These are all the string. So for this one our they will be taken, that is the ASCII value, that means American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So here they will be taken the, what is the ASCII value of H, what is the ASCII value of capital H. So here capital A, small h means, for example, here small a is equals to 95, means B, C, D, E, F, G, H, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 101, 102. So now it will be taken H is equals to 102. So that means what is the ASCII value? 102. Then according to the capital letter, that means if you are the taking the capital letter like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, that means what is the ASCII value of A means 65 66 67 68 69 70 71 72. So here the ASCII values are the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, that means 65 66 67 68, like this one. What is the ASCII value of H? That means it will become the 72. Here small a ASCII value is the not 95, it is the 97. So that means there is a difference too. So that's why our ASCII value of H is, that is nothing but a 104. That means here ASCII value is the 104. This is the ASCII values of the letters. In that means capital A means 65, small a is 97, that means H. So at the time of strcmp it will be ignored whether it is a small or capital, just it will be taken the any iverb, that means either small h or capital H. Actually our string means first one is the h a I and second one is the small h a I, that means it will be taken small h and capital H. But here strcmp means it ignoring whether it is a small or capital, it will be taken both are the same, both are the same here. That means it will be gives the simply, it will be the result is zero. That means here in our str1 and str2, in this situation the output is the both strings, the output is both strings are equal, both strings are equal. Why? Because here even though look like as a small h and capital H, both are different, but at the time of strcmp it does not thinking about the small h and capital H. So that means, so here the both strings are equal, means in the situation we will take, that means what is the strcmp means in this situation we are telling that how to, that means we are taking the strcmp and strcmp, that means I for ignore. That means we don't think about the whether it is a small or capital. That's why it means here our intention is both strings are equal. That means you are taking the I. That means the difference between the strcmp and strcmpi. But our requirement is we don't think whether it is a small or capital. Both letters are the same, so that we are using the function strcmpi. This is the strcmp means it will be ignored whether it is a small or capital. But if you want to consider, even though both are the different, that means strcmp, it means here strcmp like str1 comma str2. So what is the first one? Here it is a comparison, means it will be considered, that means h is the capital, small h is the capital. So here small h value ASCII value is 104, capital H ASCII value is 72. So then it will be taken, the first string is the this one, second string is this one, then it will be different like this, 104 minus 72 means 4 2 4 minus 2 4 10 minus 7 32. I think this is the positive value. So that means if the return value is the positive value, what we are telling that str1 is greater than str2, that means here we are getting the positive value. So in this situation at the time of strcmp it will be telling that simply str1 is greater than str2. That means string 2. String 1 is greater than string 2. But here it will both strings are equal. Why? Because we are using the I, strcmp I. Here we don't, that means strcmp means it will be considered, even though they look like as a same, but it will be considered the case, whether it is a small or capital. So this is the concept, this is the difference between the strcmp and strcmp I. So then now last function, that means if you want to combine, that is the strcat, that means you want the concatenation, that means concatenation of the both string, concatenation of two strings. So then we are taking the first one is, I will take the strcat, str1, str2, str3. According to our mathematically, in generally, it will be look like str1 is equals to str2 plus str3.